Hey everyone, Hedge here. Today we're going to be going over this CatHack build, which is really just the M5 stick plus with the CatHack firmware and a custom board that I've made. This board adds sub-gigahertz functionality, which gives it features similar to the flipper. You can record sub-gigahertz signals like garage door openers, CBS help buttons, Tesla battery door openers. It's also compatible with flipper zero files, so if you go onto GitHub and you find a bunch of .sub files, you can actually go ahead and put these on the SD card and use them just like a flipper. I'll leave a link in the description for all the materials I use for this build. While I assemble this, let me tell you a little bit about this CatHack firmware. It has Wi-Fi tools like deauthing and SSID spamming. It has Bluetooth tools like credit card skimmer detection. It has infrared capabilities like universal remotes. And with the proper hardware attached, like my board, it'll unlock sub-gigahertz functionality. Everything you see in this video can be bought for probably under 60 bucks. So at half the cost of a flipper, I think it's something cheap and fun to build and play around with. Now we'll have to program this thing. To do that, we'll need a USB-C cable and a computer. Let's cut to the computer and I'll show you how to program it. But first, let's talk about our sponsor, PCBWay. The quality of boards I'm getting from PCBWay are top-notch. Even outside of YouTube, I'm using them for my small business, and it's been a pleasure working with them. They offer a range of services from PCB manufacturing to CNC to 3D printing, all at really competitive rates industry-wide. So if you're looking to step up your electronics project with a PCB, or even just have a transparent case printed for your Flipper Zero, PCBWay has you covered. Now let's get back to the video. You'll need to download the M5 burner software. Once downloaded, install it. Once you got it installed, go ahead and open it up and click over to the Stick C tab. And then we'll search for CatHack. And it's really easy to burn. You'll just select your version, click the Burn button, and click Continue because this is an unofficial firmware. Select the COM port that your device is connected to. Then click Start. Once you see that hard resetting line, it should reboot. Now let's turn it on and have some fun with it. Let's go ahead and show off some of the sub-gigahertz functionality. So here I'll go to sub-gigahertz and then monitor. And then you can come over here to the flipper and then we'll go ahead and send a sub-gigahertz signal. And then you can see it visualized on the CatHack. And while this is cool looking, it's not really useful, so let's go ahead and show off something a little bit more functional. This is the Analyze tool, which will show you the frequency of the sub-gigahertz signal that you're receiving. And as you can see, it's really close to the actual transmitted frequency, and the signal strength is very strong. Now let's try a recording. You essentially just start a transmission while recording, and it should save, but I forgot the SD card. But once you actually throw one in, it should record. And it stores that to the SD card. What that allows you to do is use that file later and perform a replay attack. I'll demonstrate that here, and we'll go to subsend, and then the recordings. And then find the file, and you can rename these. But we'll just transmit it. As you can see, my flipper picked it up. So now that everything's working, I think we need a nice case for it. Let's hop over to Fusion 360 and design something. So I imported my models and then started trying to design a case around my device. And I'll be honest, this was actually really hard for me. The Grove connector on the bottom and the SD card slot weren't level, and so I had to kind of offset the bottom part of the case so it fit nicely. Then I would sketch on the sides and then go ahead and cut out holes where the IR emitter and the SD card slot are, and then cut out holes for the screen and the buttons. And then I had to make a cutout for the antenna. I slimmed up the top side just to make it a little bit smaller, And I also had to bring the wall closer to the USB connector. And then I added the cat face and then the word cat hack to the bottom. I thought I gave it a nice touch. And that's it, that's the final design. You should have seen how many cases I printed. I have a pile of failed designs on my desk. I'm not a very good 3D modeler, but every time I do it, I feel like I get better and better. So great experience. Totally recommend you just jump in and try to start making models for things that you have. Let's get this sent off to the bamboo slicer and I'll show you how I started printing it. I know I wanted a multicolored print and that's why I added the cat face and then the words to the bottom. So I went ahead and printed this in black carbon fiber PETG and white PETG. I've been in love with carbon fiber filaments lately. If you haven't tried it, it leaves such a nice finish. It's like a glossy matte. I don't even know how to explain it. It's just so cool looking. Then I shipped it off to the printer. After it was done printing, I started assembling it. And this is the final product. I'll throw the case up on MakeWorld and provide links in the description for all the materials I used. I will be selling these boards if you want to get one from me. But if not, also in the description will be a schematic and some Amazon links to the modules that I basically integrated into this board so you can wire it up yourself if you'd like. And that's it. I hope you liked the video. If you did, it'd mean a lot if you gave it a thumbs up or a sub. Catch you in the next one.